We're asked to classify each number as rational or irrational. Rational and irrational numbers make up the set of real numbers, where real numbers are numbers that would appear on the number line. So rational numbers, often represented by the capital letter Q, are numbers that can be written in fraction form with the form A divided by B, with A and B as integers, though B can't be zero, otherwise we'd have division by zero. In decimal form, rational numbers terminate or do not terminate and repeat. So here are several examples of rational numbers. Here we have integers, we have fractions, and then in decimal form, the decimal must terminate, as we see here with 0.4, which is a fraction would be 4/10 or 2/5, or as a decimal, it must be non-terminating but repeating. So 0.3 repeating is equal to 1/3 as a fraction. So all these are rational numbers. Irrational numbers are real numbers that are not rational, meaning they cannot be written in the form of A divided by B. In decimal form, irrational numbers do not terminate and also do not repeat. So here are two examples of irrational numbers. The square root of 5 is irrational because this does not simplify perfectly, and in decimal form, it would not terminate, but would also not repeat. And then pi is a very famous irrational number. Again, as a decimal, it does not terminate and does not repeat. Now, I do want to mention there are additional sets of numbers. There are also integers, whole numbers, and natural or counting numbers, as we see here, but all these are also rational numbers. Now, going back to our example, let's first take a look at the cube root of 27. Just because we have a radical here does not mean it's going to be irrational. We want to see if this simplifies. If it simplifies perfectly, then it would be rational. So if we take a look at the cube root of 27, if we take a look at the prime factorization of 27, 27 is equal to 9 times 3, 9 is equal to 3 times 3. So this would be the cube root of 3 cubed, and the cube root undoes the cubing, and therefore this simplifies perfectly to 3, which is rational. So the cube root of 27 is a rational number. Notice how we could write 3 as 3 over 1, which would be the form of a over b, where a and b are integers. Next we have pi, which is a very famous irrational number. In decimal form, the decimal is non-terminating and non-repeating. And let's take a look at this on a calculator. Notice how if we enter pi and then enter, the calculator only gives us a certain number of decimal places, but this decimal would continue forever, and notice how it is not repeating, which is the reason why it's irrational. Next we have the square root of 27. So there's no whole number times itself that's going to be equal to 27. We know 5 squared is equal to 25, and 6 squared is equal to 36, which means this is not going to simplify perfectly. It's going to be some non-terminating, non-repeating decimal between 5 and 6, which means the square root of 27 is irrational. Looking at this on the calculator, if we enter the square root of 27, notice how it is between 5 and 6, but this decimal is non-terminating and also not repeating, which is why the square root of 27 is irrational. Next we have 5.9. Well, 5.9 is a terminating decimal, which makes it rational. We could also write 5.9 in the form of a over b, where a and b are integers, because 5.9 is equal to 5 9/10, which would be equal to 10 times 5 is 50 plus 9, so 5 9/10 is equal to 59/10. Again, verifying 5.9 is rational. Next, we have 0.3 repeating. Because the decimal is non-terminating, but also repeating, 0.3 repeating is rational. Taking a look at this decimal more closely, 0.3 repeating is equal to 1/3. We can verify 1/3 is equal to 0.3 repeating by performing division. 1 divided by 3, well, there are no 3s in 1 because 3 is greater than 1, So this value is going to be less than 1. So we can put our decimal point here, move it up to the quotient, and now we can add a 0 in the tenths place value, and now ask how many 3s are there in 10. There are 3 3s in 10. 3 times 3 is 9. We subtract. 10 minus 9 is 1. We can keep adding zeros here to the right of the decimal point. Bring down the 0. Ask how many 3s are in 10. Again, that's 3. 3 times 3 is 9. We subtract. We get a 1. Add another 0. Bring it down. Notice how we keep getting a 10 here, and we keep asking how many 3s there are in 10, which is always going to be 3. So the 3 repeats, which is the reason why 1/3 equals 0.3 repeating. And because this is equal to 1/3, this is the reason why this decimal is rational. Next, we have the square root of 81. Well, because 81 is equal to 9 times 9, this is equal to the square root of 9 squared, which is equal to 1 factor of 9. Because we can write 9 as 9 over 1, square root of 81 is rational. The last value is the cube root of 16. If this simplifies perfectly, this would be rational. If it doesn't, it's going to be irrational. Well, because 2 to the third is equal to 8, and 3 to the third is equal to 27, this is not going to simplify nicely to a whole number value, which means this is going to be irrational. It's going to be some non-terminating, non-repeating decimal between 2 and 3. Another way to show this would be to look at the prime factorization of 16. 16 is equal to 4 times 4, and each 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So the cube root of 16 is equal to the cube root of 2 to the 4th. So because we can't write 16 as some whole number raised to the 3rd power, again, this tells us this is not going to simplify perfectly, and therefore it's going to be a non-terminating, non-repeating decimal, which makes the cube root of 16 irrational. I know you probably can't use a calculator on this type of problem, but just to see the decimal approximation for the cube root of 16, let's go and show it on the calculator. So we'll press Math, Option 4 for cube root, 16, Enter. And again, notice how we have a non-terminating, non-repeating decimal, which is the reason why the cube root of 16 is irrational. It also cannot be written in the form of a over b, where a and b are integers. I hope you found this helpful.